Hi everyone, welcome again to Tim's Vinyl Confessions. I'm Tim Durling, my wife Sarah's joining me again for this one. On this episode, we are going to be talking about the Police, because we are going to be seeing this man in a couple of months, Sarah's favorite, Sting, Mr. Sumner. Just got that one pop figurine. It's kind of cool. It's got a little of the Zenyatta Mandata cover on the back there. So yeah, we decided to try anyway and list our top five favorite Police songs, and this was not easy.
No, I found it very difficult, actually. Far more difficult than I thought it would be. And I don't know why I had it in my head that it would be simple, but I had it narrowed down to, I don't even know how many. I could have used a few extra, let's put it that way.
Yeah, well, one of the reasons I think is that the Police only did five albums. They weren't around very long, but they were pretty consistent albums. So in amongst all of those, there's a lot of great songs to choose from, a lot of hit singles. So
a lot of hit singles.
Not all of the songs we picked were singles, actually, which is kind of cool. So each picked five songs, but we each also picked one honorable mention. So I'll let Sarah start us off. What's your honorable mention? What just missed your top five?
So mine's the original, 1980, right? Don't Stand So Close to Me. Just because I like it's very evocative of a certain time frame, I think, to me, the way that it sounds. Even though it doesn't really sound particularly 1980, I wouldn't say.
No.
Typically,
they were sort of out of in their own
thing.
Yeah.
But just the nostalgia of it, I think I was very young at the time, but there's that Police sound from the early 80s anyway, in general, this kind of encapsulates that for me.
My honorable mention is actually a song I've only been familiar with maybe the last couple of years. I think it was one of Rick Beato's videos that he talked about the song. Synchronicity One, from obviously their final album, Synchronicity, in 1983. It's very fast, it's very frantic, and it's just a really, really cool song. And if you're not familiar with it, if you've only got one of the hits packages, I would check out Synchronicity 1, and it's important to make that distinction because they're two very different songs. That's my honorable mention. So now we'll start with Sarah's number five Police song, preferred Police song.
So I picked Wrapped Around Your Finger, and I went back and forth on a couple of these last night I was making my list. I guess Tim had made his list prior.
Sting traipsing through the candles, right, in slow motion. The video.
It's not even so much about the video. That's what's funny about the Police for me. My love of their music doesn't necessarily have anything to do with the music videos, and that's in spite of, we've talked before about my great love of music videos. Are you smirking because of Sting?
Of Sting, yeah.
Yeah, but I didn't appreciate him in that way. I was too young, Tim, to appreciate him in that way.
So my number five goes all the way back to the first album, Outlandos D'Amour, which this is really, really odd cassette, and I don't know where this came from. This is not official. It's not on A&M Records. It says GMR, so it's not an official album. But anyway, that is the correct album cover, their first album from 1978. We've got pets in here, so if you hear like extraneous noises.
I want to grab him though, because I think
Hold on. So the noises you've been making in the background come from this guy right here. And so his name, when we got him,
was Sting.
Yeah.
He was part of the No Mo May litter at Dunroman, which is a local. It's not SPCA, that's not really
shelter.
Yeah. And so he was Sting, and his other litter mates had similar bee names. He's known at the shelter as one of the bee cats. And because his name was Sting, Tim felt very strong.
Well, that for two reasons. Number one is your love of Sting, but number two, all of the pets in your family have human names.
They do.
So I said, well, if his name is Sting, you got to call him Gordon. And he's very Gordon. He's a very, very bad boy.
He's super bad.
But he's very handsome, so. So yes, my number five song comes from the first album, Atlantis Timur, and it is Can't Stand Losing You. If you want to see something disturbing, look at the single cover, the single sleeve for this album. Anyway, it's just a typical early Police song, but catchy, really, really catchy. And, you know, we're talking about videos. I get a kick out of the video for this song because it's just them lip syncing, but Sting, for some reason, has these huge glasses on. So that's my number five pick.
So number four, I've chosen Synchronicity 2, which is, it's kind of quirky. I don't know how else to describe it, but I've always liked it. There's,
Gordon, Sting.
That's really what we want.
It's great, Gordon. Thank you. That's wonderful. Video.
Yeah.
Synchronicity 2. Yes.
I don't know what else I want to say other than it's...
Well, I've got more to say about it, so...
Okay, you go ahead.
Later.
Oh.
Later.
Okay.
In its place. Sure. My number four song is the 1986 version of Don't Stand So Close to Me, or Don't Stand So Close to Me 86, which originally came out on this this best of, which is called Every Breath You Take. Actually, this is a 1995 reissue, because originally when it came out in 86, it had a black cover. And it was called Every Breath You Take, the singles. Now it's called The Classics. And it was new at that time. And, you know, Sting had already released his first album, Dream of the Blue Turtles. And famously, these three guys, brilliant, volatile. And it's a wonder that they got five albums out and lasted as long as they did. They didn't get along. And Stuart Copeland, I think, I don't know if he broke his arm or broke his leg. The drums on the 86 version are... I think a Fairlight program drums. They don't sound too bad, but definitely don't have that snap that Stuart Copeland usually has. And a lot of people, I didn't realize this until later, but this is actually quite a maligned version of the song. But I've always had a big nostalgia for it because I remember when this song was out. It was the only Police single that was out when I was actively listening to the radio and especially watching much music. And I actually didn't realize until many years later, this song didn't hit the top 40 in the States. It tapped out at 46. I didn't know that either. I really like, it's practically...
a different song.
You know, unlike, say, Whitesnake, Here I Go Again, if you compare the 82 version with the 87 version, they're very different recordings, but it's the same song. It's almost completely transformed. I really like the melancholy vibe of the 86 version. I love Andy Summers' guitar line that he puts through it. And actually, it suits the lyrics a little bit more accurately than does the original, because the original's really peppy, really upbeat. It's got kind of that ska thing going on.
And when we listened to it last night, the original put me more in mind of Every Little Thing.
Yeah.
Like, in terms of the kind of happy, joyful vibe.
But yeah, I do have a soft spot for the 86 version, so that's my number four.
So number three, I have Spirits of the Material World. And it's kind of got like that similar reggae like feel. And actually, like, I had a hard time between my number three and number four. I was back and forth on a couple of entries. I did have Walking on the Moon listed at one point, and then I crossed it out because I kind of felt like that and Spirits kind of have a similar reggae like vibe. So I thought I would just narrow it down to the one.
I'm not sure if it's accurate. I call Spirits of the Material World more of a ska because it's faster, sure. Which ska is kind of like fast reggae. Yeah, Walking on the Moon is very, very much reggae sounding. I mean, that's what they almost called Regatta de Blanc. It's literally what it says is white reggae.
It's like a vibe.
Yeah, but yeah. Spirits of the Material World I really like. And it came very, very close to making my list, or at least the honorable mention. So my number three, Sarah's already mentioned Synchronicity 2, which actually is not on this this best of. It's an oversight.
No, it's not.
It was a top 10 single, I believe it was. I like this song because to me this is kind of the closest that the Police ever came to hard rock. It's very aggressive. It's got kind of like a angular, jagged guitar in it, and of course, some of that too comes from the imagery of the video, where it's sort of like a lot of videos that came out in 1983, 84, it's kind of a post-apocalyptic type of thing. And
I don't know the video.
It's very dark. Like they're each
strange.
they're each playing on their own pile of garbage, like mm-hmm. surrounded by water, and Sting kind of has a Billy Idol look going on because his hair is a little spiky in this one, and it's also I think I can safely say this. It's the only top 40 single I can think of with the word crotch in it. I think there's some of Sting's best lyrics, and I love the fact that, I mean, it is what the concept of synchronicity is, how something that happens somewhere else affects something else that happens, you know, many miles away, as the song goes. And the horror imagery of it, have you, something rises to the surface of a dark Scottish loch. But then the final one is like something, there's a shadow on the door of a cottage on the shore of a dark Scottish lake, and it's like unresolved. Like it's something out of a horror movie, but
it's a little bit X-Files.
But it's got like, it's, I think another hard rock thing about it, it's Stella has one of her toys. don't mind our fur babies here. It's got an F sharp riff to it. So I just always really liked this song anyway. That's my number three.
For number two, I have King of Pain. And I was just looking at the lyrics. And it's rather dark, too. I mean, if you're going to start out and say there's a little black spot on the sun today, it's the same old thing as yesterday.
Yeah, it's funny. They don't have, like, the brackets part. It's like there's a little black spot on the sun today, and it's like, that's my soul up there.
Yeah, and I love that.
I remember, I think we studied this in English class as a poem when I was in grade 11. Yeah.
We did not.
One of the several, one of the many hit singles from their final album, Synchronicity.
It's my destiny to be the king of pain. I mean, it is dark. They do include later.
Oh, okay. They did, you know, Sting has a tendency to do that. He would have like a happy sounding musical piece.
Yes.
Married to lyrics that were quite dark, quite sad, melancholy. But
even with his solo stuff, that's very characteristic.
Yeah, especially with the solo stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. So my number two is actually, I don't think it was a single in North America. And I have to thank my buddy Chad for introducing me to this song because I'd never heard it before. It's from the third album, Zenyatta Mandata. It's When the World is Falling Down, You Make the Best of What's Still Around. And it's so fun sounding and chipper sounding, and you're just kind of bobbing your head to it, but the lyrics are dark. It's sort of like, you know, and I don't know if this was a nuclear war song, a Cold War song. I mean,
I don't know,
that was such a big topic of the 80s, and, you know, sadly, some things never change. But yeah, I've always had a soft spot for that song, and it's not one that you hear all the time, but it's certainly worthy of checking out and giving another look. Number one.
My number one is, and it's always been my favorite. It's one of my all-time favorite songs. But now I love it for sentimental reasons, and that would be Every Little Thing She Does is Magic. And we included it as part of our wedding ceremony. Tim very graciously put...
I looped the intro, so there's no vocals.
Right.
To give her and everybody time to walk out. Yes, very special. We might as well both talk about it. It's my number one as well.
So it is for romantic reasons, like emotional reasons.
But
now,
it's always been
a
fantastic pop song. And I've always been a fan of Stuart Copeland's
drumming.
Like, and this, I always say that, you know, he's got that tight snare sound that sounds like it's going to take your head off. It's so tight. And he just plays with such force. And this song's got a little bit of everything to it. It's got gorgeous piano melody in it. And, you know, Andy Summers always has just the right guitar part. But, you know, there's some of Sting's best, I think, romantic lyrics.
I think there's
a big enough umbrella, but it's always me that ends up getting wet. And
it's just very charming. It's very charming, joyful to me, anyway, or I feel that it is. It's always made me happy. There's something about it. I don't know if it's the nostalgia. I mean, it is from 1980, right? There's something about it.
I put the wrong year on that. Look at that. That's from 81. It's from...
Okay, I thought you told me it was the year after.
It's from Ghost of the Machine, okay. Sorry.
Thanks, Tim.
Yeah. But yeah, it's funny because I know it was at the time, again, I have to talk about Much Music. They played a lot of Police videos, even though most of them were older. But I remember seeing this one a lot. I mean, it alternates between the three of them in the studio, and then they're on the back of a truck, and they're Sting's dancing. He's got his little hat on, and but yeah, it's a fun song. It's got a fun coda where it's EO. Like there's no, you know, not a lot of not a lot of words, but yeah, and you know, like Lightning in a Bottle. These three guys captured, and we not too long ago we watched that. The documentary that Andy Summers did, surviving, I think it was called Can't Stand Losing You, Surviving the Police.
I think so.
And, you know, even on their reunion tour, it would show them sniping at each other, and which is to say Sting sniping at the other two.
So I don't think they liked him much either, though.
No.
Seemingly.
No. But whatever it was that they had, there's a definite difference between the Police and Sting's solo career. Not that he hasn't made great music, but the three of them made such a distinctive sound. And I think if you took either of those
elements away.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I don't think Stuart Copeland was their first. No, I'm wrong. Andy Summers was not their first guitar player, but on their recordings, it was always those three. But yeah, the three of them just created this completely unique sound that, I mean, never goes away. Cats are destroying stuff in the background. What would your top five Police songs be? List them in the comments below. And thanks again for watching Tim's Vinyl Confessions.